not charging. So the message we're getting is no message, 0 amp draw. It was saying unable to use the accessory earlier. And now it's not even saying that. Here we go. USB accessories not supported. Unlock iPhone to use accessories too. And then obviously it's not going to work. So, no charge. And our charger is definitely working. As you can see on my phone. Here we charge. Okay, so. Let me get right into it. Such a bad angle in this video, but just gonna try and make this work. So normally the first thing you want to do is always disconnect the battery so you're not getting any burnt backlight issues or anything like that. I have done loads of these, but I always like to, I'm gonna have it off. Okay, so that's a missing screw. Okay, I'm in the habit of trying to, you know, organize my screws. So that's the first one. Well, really good idea would be to actually test to see if it is a charging port or if it's IC. In this industry, or with any repair industry at least anyway, it's never a good idea to assume anything. Always test and make sure it really is the problem. So now that we connect the charging port, we're getting charging amperage. So once I connect the battery, we are gonna pull close to an amp. We are pulling good numbers. So, without showing you the rest of the mess, you can see that it's pulling 1.2 amps, and before it was at zero. So we know it's definitely a charging port. Sorry, I'm just trying to hide all the mess. That's why I'm at this weird angle, but I'm eventually going to clean up and make it a bit more presentable. So these are not where they're going with, so I don't have to worry about that. Or to be fair, I do know where a lot of screws go anyway, but it's just always good practice to organize the screws. Right, so there's that one. And you got these two. So that, that, and that. And then we've got this. Slightly tricky because you've got disconnected, you've got another one underneath it for the some sort of antenna, Wi-Fi, GPS, network, some sort of antenna. Never had to work out what it actually is for, but I do know it is an antenna. Right, so that's broken off, it's interesting. Screw as well. Put that next to that. Okay, that's there. Now these, the charging port obviously goes underneath the motherboard, and that's the other antenna. There we go. And then our vibrator comes off. And again, that is one screw that I definitely know where it goes, so I don't have to worry about that one. Vibrator. And we have two screws under, not underneath, but on the frame. So one, two. Right, so that's done. So that's all the screws for the charging port. Now it's just a case of removing the port. That's one mic. That's the second mic. So there's that. Obviously, disconnect the battery. Always disconnect the battery. Just get out of the way. Another thing that makes it a bit slightly easier is to remove our SIM tray. SIM tray goes there, and then there's a little sort of pin that comes out, so you want to put it outwards so that way the motherboard can flex upwards easily. So that's that. We need to remove our charging port, so that comes out there. Now this is the slightly tricky bit, so for me, I kind of pulling away where now obviously the battery connector that the way, so if I just kind of like wiggle that at an angle, that will pop off nicely, as you can see. Then with our new port, I've noticed always whenever I replace these, I always, before, because that's double-sided tape, before I push down on it, I always connect it to the motherboard first, that way it lines up. Before that sticks on, like trying to, we want to connect our charging port to the board. So once that's connected, then we can go ahead and try and line it up again. now all lined up. And we can push down that so we know the charging port is secured in place. And push down on this. Just work it back in reverse. So once the transport's in place, mics are in place, then we go back to form it on it. So there's that screw. There's the second screw there. Be careful not to confuse the outside screw holes with doll screw holes, and make sure that our screw holes are empty there so we can secure the screen with them. Then we can put our vibrator on. Goes on, and we can put this antenna back on. It's ever so fiddly, but once you get the hang of it, you're okay. So, as you can see, it's in place. Press that on. Then again, the speaker goes in a bit weird, so that side goes in first. Kind of lift the motherboard up, let the speaker settle in, and push back down again, and that secures our speaker. And then we can... Oh, sorry, I forgot. That needs to go in first. I think they're called pentel screws or something like that. There's that. And then we've got our antenna connector that goes on. We've got this one that goes on. SIM card tray can go in now. Connect our antenna. Then we got that middle screw. That screw there. So that is in now. I've got that screw there. And we've got these. missing this screw. I can't remember, was that even in there? Can't remember now, but whether it's there or not, I can put a screw in. I get a lot of phones coming in for repair, and I see very oftenly where phones are missing screws. Now, wherever you can, always try your best to just add them screws in. A lot of people choose to not put them in, or either lose them screws and not replace them, but it's always just, you know, good practice to find a phone missing screws. Then I definitely know that one was definitely missing. Oh, one more gun. That screw was definitely missing when I opened the phone, so I'll put it in. It's just always good practice to put them in. They are there for a reason. There are screws that you can get away with not putting in, but it's just best to put all the screws in if you can, anyway. Testing time. The job done, and we did see that the phone was charging anyway, so us sorting that meter anyway. And we're putting 1.1, 1.3, 1.41, 1.3, and it's charging. So normal message off, unlock the phone. Charging this side, flip it around, it's on the other side as well. So that is done. Now we just need to put all the remaining screws in. Another really important thing is next to the camera we've got non-magnetic screws. I think an iPhone 8 anyway, the iPhone 7 you had one screw that was it iPhone 7? iPhone 6? Yeah, the iPhone 5s. Yeah, iPhone 5s, you had one screw on it, which is not an magnetic, which is right next to the camera. But on these ones, all the screws are on magnetic, from what I know. So if we kind of tilt over to where we can see the screws, that is not really magnetic. See that? It's just, you know, such a dull thing. But if I pick up, you can almost hear the metal clicking. And this one, well, that one you could, but that one not really. That's quite magnetic. Maybe I'll just magnetize it. Can you see the difference? But anyway, point is that those screws are not magnetic, or at least not magnetic enough, because they are going to be put around the camera, and magnets can damage the camera in the long run. So I would be wary about that. So don't put magnetic screws next to our camera. Knowing when I do this, I can never get it to stick to my screws. Because I'm making a video. That's why. But I struggle putting these screws in. I have to get a tweezer and do it with a tweezer normally. But when I'm making a video, this happens. Okay, so with iPhone 8, it's, you know, it's not like the iPhone 7 where you have to clip it in. It's just, you know, you can put bottom in first, top in first. It makes no difference. As long as you've got it lined up in place and it just clicks. That's that click and click. And it's done. The top's in, bottom's in, and then we've got the two bottom screws. That's that, and that is that. Some charge for the customer. Got to be fully charged for them to collect. Thank you for watching, and sorry about the mess.